Time for another episode of the Thought Project, just so you know. And today we're going to be playing Gwen Stefani's The Sweet Escape. But maybe not as long. I'm not going to dance as much today. Okay, I think that's enough for today. This is gonna be a little bit shorter show and try to get through some material more quickly. As far as economics go, I didn't see anything too major, except there were some reports about the yuan and Japanese currency having some issues. I think that's kind of going to be expected these days with what's going on, sort of world economies. As far as the U.S., it seems like the habit patterns are staying the same, that people aren't spending as much and restricting their activities accordingly, but especially not spending on extra frivolous things like movies, entertainment, events generally, but then again, also spending on things that are kind of easier, more simple to do. And really down to like the basics as far as what they're consuming and what's easy and like makes sense for them. As far as housing, I've noticed that there was one report that housing reports were going up in the northern part of the U.S. in areas that have been cheaper, but then they're coming down a little bit in areas that are more expensive. Now, does that mean they're going to be the same price? No. You're still going to have cheaper housing in the areas that have been cheaper. They're just a little bit more expensive. And the areas that are overpriced are still going to be really, really overpriced. So I do need to go through something. There was a report yesterday from a friend of mine, the DCR resource. Then an A, I think that's an ALL96300 or an RSD898. But that could even be an AII96300, but it's called an RSD898. It's a Russian plane. It flew to Washington, D.C. yesterday at the Rossiya, R-O-S-S-I-Y-A Airlines Special Flight Squadron's insignia. That's used by the Russian government generally. Their officials in the past have used them to pick up spies from the U.S. that we were letting them have. I don't understand why we're so nice. You know, based on my experiences and how difficult the Russian government and the KGB and FSB has been in their behavior, I mean, not just the entertainment industry, but like what I went through researching Wilhelm, Kendrick, Fredward, Patricia, Buffalo Bill, like all of that, those people are all real. They're just names I've given them for the purpose of the show. But the fights in the U.S. are very real. And the damage and the economic damage is very real. And the theft is very real. So I don't understand why we're being so nice with Russia and giving them time to come pick up their spies. You know, I mean, I guess it's nice to get them moving back to Russia if that's the case, but why haven't they ever picked up Kendrick? I mean, why haven't they ever picked up Fredward? Why haven't they ever picked up Buffalo Bill, Patricia, Dan? Like, why are these people still allowed to operate in the U.S. and to attack and hurt people and steal, right? So, and we need to talk a little bit about the country club culture here in the U.S. So, the country club culture was really set up by the FSB and KGB, and the culture was basically that you were supposed to act a certain way, have money, and that you had to belong to the right network. In reality, you didn't have to have money. You didn't have to actually, you did have to dress a certain way, but you didn't actually really have to fit that. And you could very much be a part of them simply because you were part of the Russian business structure. For actual clubs, like for example, Hugh Hefner really broke trends by running a gentleman's club called the Playboy Clubs, where in order to attend them, you had to pay the fee, wear a suit, and behave, right? I'll say it again. Pay the fee, wear a suit, and behave. He actually broke a trend that the Russians had set up with their country clubs by doing that, and he actually later had to close down the clubs as a result of it because they figured out that he was actually breaking with their culture, because the one thing you weren't allowed to do with the Playboy Clubs was run Russian business, right? You had to wear the suit, behave, no Russian business, and pay the fee. I'm not saying be a Playboy bunny. I'm saying the guy broke a trend in business. He actually went against them. And then he actually ended up losing the clubs as a result because they figured out what he was doing and they couldn't conduct their business inside of them, so they got mad at him. Just so you know. Anyway, so, you know, there's a shooter that's actually just been penalized today in Colorado. He attacked the, it's supposed to be an LGBTQ club, but he shot 5 people, 19 injured, and 46 counts of attempted murder. His name was, he was convicted by John Michael McHenry, sentenced at 23 years old, and his name was Jordan Lee. I may not have that name right, but 2022 massive shooting at Club Q in Colorado Springs. Let me look at this for a really quick second. Anyways, that may have been an example, because one thing I saw the country club culture is that people like myself, like I went to a number of country clubs all over the U.S. and a lot of it was when I was stuck in years I deal with Cersei and Wilhelm and that sort of network. And it was very much so I didn't have money, but I was allowed to attend because people enjoyed having me around. And I will tell you, the club I went to in Johnstown was not bad, behaved. The Janesville club in Wisconsin that I went to a few times with friends that without Cersei Wilhelm, thank you, was probably the best behaved one. It was also one of the smallest ones I've ever seen. And they didn't allow Cersei Wilhelm to join or attend there. But I was actually allowed to go with other people who were considered well-behaved members. So some people would actually have argued that maybe it wasn't a real country club because it wasn't part of the Russian business organization. So I'm just trying to find, but the worst I ever went to was I'm just looking up the name of this guy. The worst one I ever went to was in Dubuque, Iowa. And that was one where Buffalo Bill used to go and eat. Oh, Anderson Lee Aldrich. I didn't get his name right at all. So it's Anderson Lee Aldrich. Pled guilty this week. So, really scary stuff. But anyways, the point is that, you know, Buffalo Bill used to go and eat at the one in Dubuque all the time. The Dubuque Golf and Country Club is probably the most dangerous, disgusting place I've ever been. And you would never know. It was a big, beautiful club. It looked really great. But what went on there was horrible. And there were actually people tortured and murdered there and just put through really heinous stuff. And Buffalo Bill used to go over there and eat there all the time for free. And then he would do enforcing stuff and beat people up and torture them, sometimes kill them. And none of this has ever really been investigated fully. I don't even know if the club's still open. But it was a horrible, horrible place. And it's the kind of stuff that inspires films like Caddyshack, which most people don't understand Caddyshack. They think it was a goofball movie about a guy who acted crazy club. And then, you know, the gopher, quote-unquote, animal blows the whole place up. And so if you understand what the movie was really about, which was destroying that Russian country club culture in the U.S., then it's one of the best films you'll ever see. And probably the funniest. And Bill Murray's a genius. And the screenwriters were geniuses. But I can tell you some people who made that movie got in trouble for it because of what it was actually after, which was destroying the KGB, FSB culture in the U.S. And, of course, you know, the FBI in the 80s would have called the gopher a terrorist, even though he was actually an abused character who just went out of there, right? So it's tricky, right? Be careful of this stuff, you know? Like, don't think you got it when you don't got it. But you have to look at those kinds of issues. And I'm just kind of frustrated because while I decided Kendrick was extremely mentally ill, he was also someone who liked to steal a lot from me and was completely impossible in discussions. And I think it's worth discussing that, you know, he benefited a lot from Buffalo Bill and Patricia and Doug stealing. And, you know, that, I'm sorry, Dan, I mean. And Dan stealing my image, and even Patricia did as well. And to note that he said he couldn't control any of these people, but he was still supposed to be the head of a company and a founder of it. Well, then he's not. You know, you're not a founder if you can't control them, and you're really dishonest if you think it's okay to just collect all the money from him. That's insane. So that's how that's going to go, and that's going to be my position. I've never been paid for, like, decades of work. And I'm a 43-year-old woman. And what I've been through just, you know, the fact that Kendrick tried to approach me again in Charlottesville and the violence there, it's very clearly related to Russian activity. It's worth being scared of and concerned about. So that was Charlottesville, Virginia. But I want to note something. Why, and I say this pulling up a thread from an older show, why would anybody bother with the U.S. Copyright Office? Because there's still a push for people to register with them. But if everything can be stolen, you know, if all these different singers can take people's work, you know, Jennifer Lopez and Taylor Swift, like they can all just steal people's work and then make a bunch of money off of it. And these enforcers, because Buffalo Bill has worked for both of them, why would it matter to even bother with copyrights and pay a bunch of fees in a copyright office where some of the staff have been really mean and insulting, called women and other artists prostitutes and threatened to have us killed for just trying to register our artistic works and protect them? And that's really key to know, because they actually don't have as much authority as they used to because of their behavior. And they've gone to a lot of lengths to establish more broad copyright law. So you need to understand that I actually have copyrights on certain works because I performed them. And I really could pull some people into court over it because they haven't paid for it. So what happened is that I began performing a lot of the works before they then went to the radio or wherever else. So these other performers put them out because they were trying to perform my work and hadn't paid for it. And they're also not real performers, you know. Synth voices, don't dance, don't perform, are basically just running drugs. Part of the KGB, FSB in the U.S. Sorry, you know, it's just the reality everyone's got to deal with. So why would anyone respect the copyright office anymore? They wouldn't. You know, and it almost seems like it's still set up for a certain network of people to try to give legitimacy from that Russian network of businesses that's fake, to try to give legitimacy to their stealing other people's work. And it means nothing because so many people are aware of the plight of people like myself who've actually created the material in advance and shown convincingly to the U.S. government that they were the original person who created it, because I have actually proved that in front of a number of lawyers and agents. So now I'm saying a lawsuit, honey, I'm waiting on some intellectual property law that relates to intelligence violations and weird stuff with people from abroad, because this is a lot of Russian internationals, Russian mafia stuff. So I'm kind of waiting for that to be figured out. But also I'm just living my life, because that's the most important thing, right? You know, I'm a model now, officially on OnlyFans. I have a few subscribers. I'm 43-year-old. Oh well. And, you know, I've got a few influencing projects, and I'm moving on with my life, you know? That's kind of how it goes, right? It's how it goes for sane people. And never forget that, like, with Cersei and Wilhelm, they were so incredibly abusive to me. They always wanted to make the point that nobody was supposed to be allowed to move on with their life or be happy. It was all being controlling. And I say this because Cersei was definitely really high up in the KGB, or still is, and she always said she didn't want people to be happy. And it was all about them wanting to decide how you think and how you felt. And instead of people making decisions for themselves, because they wanted to be in control, they were supposed to decide if you were happy or not happy. You were never supposed to have it for yourself. And they all very openly expressed and said that. Even Kendrick said it to me years ago. I couldn't believe it. Why would you tell somebody that? That's just sick and weird. That's just a bizarre person who wants to decide how other people are supposed to feel and pretend like he's supposed to be in charge of how other people feel, and he has no right to it. It's just crazy. And to express it and talk about it so disgustingly. He actually said, he's like, no, I'm going to control how you feel. You have the right to have your own feelings. I'm supposed to be in charge of it. No, you're not. You're not in charge of the way other people feel. You don't get that right, or what they think, or what they decide about you. In fact, you pretty much have no control over it. Good luck. And the U.S. Defense Intelligence Agency agrees on that kind of thing. So I know that from working with some people who work there on these problems, because I want these people out of my life. And I mean out of it. So Nicki Minaj is currently being pushed out of her neighborhood in Los Angeles. She's living in Hidden Hills. There was a change.org petition put forward by Beverly Borden to get her to leave. And her partner, Kenneth Perry, is a registered sex offender, but he didn't register right away in California, so he got in trouble, had to stay home for a year. And she's also being sued for copyright infringement. I'm just wondering if she really understood, like, what she was doing and bringing him to California and trying to live in that neighborhood. At the same time, I'm trying to understand why some of these other people that are offenders who've also lived in California are allowed to walk around and do whatever they want. Like, why is Nicki Minaj having problems? Because I believe it's valid. I think it's valid. I think she's probably committed copyright infringement. The guy's probably sketchy. But why is it okay for her to be under scrutiny but not some of these other people? And I'm saying that because this big Hollywood agency, you know, is out there still. You know, Kendrick founded it, and Patricia, Dan, Buffalo Bill are all involved. Why are they not being held accountable too? Why is that not public? Just a little curious, just curious. So that's going to end today's show. And today's show is going to end actually with me singing the Star Spangled Banner for you, which I already put up a little standalone video for people to use for 4th of July. I wanted you to have that, but I'm going to sing it again just to close out the show today, because it's going to be a short show. Well, actually, we're going back to the shorter format, because I was starting to make half-hour shows. It's just too long. People like shorter stuff, so. And I really appreciate all of you who've been following the show and involved in content and, you know, the dancing and everything else, too, because I've seen that a lot of you really like the dance video. So, and you're perfectly free to come and be a subscriber and follow my modeling pictures, too, on OnlyFans at Deborah K. It's DeBorahKay on OnlyFans. So, anyways, here we go. Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. Oh, the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets red glare above bursting in air gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled for this episode of The Thought Project, just so you know.